Hey there, thanks for stopping by. So, these are the remains of my Metabo keyless drill chuck, model Futuro Plus S2M. It was both jamming and slipping through constantly, so I wanted to try to repair it, but I had no idea how to get it open. So instead of throwing it away, I decided to rip it apart violently and turn it into a video to maybe help other people having the same problem. So, let's have a look at our parts. These here are the three jaws, which we see here, which have threads on this side. And this is the contact surface with the drill. Here we see a peak of the center part, which extends all the way through and is the most complicated and the most important part of the chuck. This is the upper part of the grip, which we see here. This is a plastic part, which extends quite a bit, both through the top and through the bottom. These parts are all fragments of the same part. I just had to break it apart into a lot of pieces to be able to get through it. And this is the lower part of the grip. This is some kind of dust protection ring, I'm guessing. This is a spring which is responsible for the clicking mechanism. This is some kind of middle part which goes inside here and goes around here and is responsible also for the clicking mechanism. This is a small bearing that keeps the nut from having too much friction and wear. This is the nut, which engages with these threads and moves the jaws. And this is the lower surface for the bearing. Basically, I think they used an extra ring. It goes on here, and I think they used an extra ring to have a harder surface, which is more wear resistant than the base material. I can't get it on quite all the way because it's quite tight, but it would go on here. So I'm gonna take it off again to not be in the way. Right. So these jaws go in here. One, two, three. Sure, they all extend the same. And the nut goes around here. I think they made it in two pieces so it can be assembled. And if we now turn the center part, we see the jaws moving in and back out. So this is how it generally works. Least if it doesn't get stuck somewhere. No. So let's put the assembly groups together that are connected non-detachably later. We have Let's put this out again. This ring goes in here, and the lower part of the grip goes on here. This is kind of a milled surface, so it's more of a friction fit. Then we have the upper part of the grip, which holds this plastic piece. This is kind of a tight press fit, but because we have a crack here, we can assemble it easily. Goes like this. And all these little parts belong to the same part. So I think this is one of the teeth that stands out here. There are three of them. These are like one, and that's the other, I guess. And I think I lost the third one, but this is how it looks. The ring, this dust collect dust cover, snaps onto these things that extend here. So it goes like this, and I think the dust ring snaps on top of them, which is why it is so annoying to disassemble, because it's like a snap that cannot be taken off easily. This thing goes inside here, which I can't do now because we have ripped it apart and it doesn't fit anymore, and it's all a bit bent. But how it would work is the nut is connected inside here, the two parts. And before the nut, the spring goes in, which is this thing. This is responsible for the clicking mechanism, because this hook here, this little hook, engages with these teeth here, like so. And when the clicking mechanism is engaged, the spring is compressed a bit, which I will explain in a second, and the kick is here. Maybe you can see it's kicking. So this goes inside here. Need to make sure we get the sides correct, because the holes are of different sizes. So the spring looks through this hole here and through the hole on the other side. Get some pliers to cram this in place. Exactly like down a bit, like this. So the spring is peeking out through the two holes here, and how the clicking mechanism engages is this goes on top of here, and when we are not tightening the drill, it can spin freely. And when we start hitting resistance, what happens is this plastic part has an inner shape that looks like this. So it gets tighter at one spot. And when the jaws start to engage the drill, these things here compress the spring on these two points where it looks outside. And the spring then engages with these teeth I've shown before. And this is what causes the mechanism to click. So this goes together like so. The nut goes on here first, actually, like this. And then this thing is put over it. It doesn't quite fit now, but it would go all the way over the nut. And then the nut is connected non-detachably with some small notches you can see here on the sides. So this and the nut is one part that moves together. And the bearing would also go in between here, but because I couldn't press the ring in place, I couldn't put in the bearings either for this demonstration. So after this thing is on, this part goes over the top. It would go all the way down to about here, so that there's only the gap for the plastic part. So this and this would be together. Now here comes the only part I'm not sure about what it does, which is this ring here, but I'm pretty sure goes into this notch here, and I'm guessing here is a notch that goes all the way around, and I'm guessing it's for engaging with the lower surface of this thing here, so the upper grip is held in place and can simply be taken off the whole chuck. That's what I'm thinking it could be for, but I'm not 100% sure, as said. So, yeah, that's basically it. As for how I would try to disassemble it with what I know now is, I would probably take a wrench and engage this hexagon here, and then take a big pair of pliers and grip this surface here and try to twist it apart. I think this should work because here it's like only a milled surface. It's not like totally impossible to get apart. So I think this could work. If we get this thing off, maybe we can get then access to this ring, which is inside this plastic thing, maybe. So probably we can somehow get this ring out then and take this whole part off. And then we could get in and see where the problem is and maybe repair it. So yeah, that's basically it. If this video was helpful for you, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, just drop me a comment. So thanks for watching and have a good day.